Lonnie King of Westlake is in flight school, just 5 hours away from becoming a pilot so he can fly drones commercially.
Right here is Cleveland Hopkins Airport. Here's where we're at actually on the map. So anything inside this ring, this manufacturer will not allow it to take off or fly.
And while King follows the rules set by the Federal Aviation Administration, he says there are plenty of people who don't.
The rules are currently 5 nautical miles from the actual airport. So, you know, a lot of people don't understand how many is a nautical mile, you know, so they just go out there with their, most of them are toys, granted most of them are toys, but some of them are capable of going pretty far and pretty high.
Monday afternoon, the FAA says a drone was spotted around 1,000 feet, less than a mile away from Cleveland Hopkins International Airport. That's against the rules. They immediately made the airport aware of the situation, who in turn called the police and the FBI.
Well, know before you fly. You know, they're actually pushing out a lot of good information now, but basically getting people educated on the rules.
The FAA says the rules include fly below 400 feet, keep the aircraft within visual line of sight at all times, remain well clear of and do not interfere with manned aircraft operations, don't fly within 5 miles of an airport, and don't fly near people or stadiums. Now, according to the FAA, anyone operating an unmanned aircraft that could pose a hazard to a manned aircraft could face fines or even jail time. And while there was no impact to the airport's operations Monday, King says situations like these can have an impact on future pilots like him.
Being a pilot, I could see the dangers, you know, and actually before, you know, you don't think, oh, this little toy can't hurt an airplane. I'm not going to go that high. But realistically, flying an airplane, it's that toy could definitely cause some damage.
In Cleveland, Melissa Reed, Fox 8 News.